everybody. Yeah, I've been working on blockchain applications quite a lot. And today I will be speaking, sharing some experience about how blockchain can help enterprises and what kind of challenges there could be in the integration process. Yeah, it could be a boring topic for many of you, but that's I know that many startups, they try to integrate blockchain into a variety of like real businesses, and they failed, and there are a few reasons for that. And yeah, I had some experience with that, so I want to share it. My experience is that I have a background in information security. I used to be a software developer, project manager. I was bored with my regular job. It was in Ukraine. And I decided to go like one way to Silicon Valley and see what's going on in there. So that was in early 2014. And it happened to be that I was right in the middle of this bubble of Bitcoin that time. So I met everybody, and I happened to speak at the local Bitcoin meetup. And I was invited to join a startup called Stellar. That's the same guy who founded Ripple, Mt. Gox, and built eDonkey Network. So that was quite interesting experience. And then I worked there, and meanwhile created a company with my partners, Distributed Lab, which is working on tokenization platforms for enterprises. So now we are trying to create financial internet, which we believe will consist of accounting systems that are interoperable, can talk to each other, like using like the same language. So that's our mission. First of all, when we talk about blockchain in enterprises, what do we actually mean? Because people really use different, they understand blockchain differently. Bitcoin enthusiasts, they think about particularly Bitcoin blockchain. And financial people usually talk about blockchain as a technology to do something. And startups, they use word blockchain when they mean their own private blockchain or own implementation. And so when you apply features from Bitcoin blockchain to some other thing, it might not work. So there are a couple of myths that I summarized in here. That's mainly of financial people believe in them. And CEOs of companies that don't really dig deeply into that. So they sometimes believe that blockchain can verify any data, that it's fully immutable, allows instant transactions, that it's encrypted. Have you heard this? I think like if I ask in the audience, some like 5% of people think it's encrypted. Or even some people believe that blockchain can replace their servers. So they are going from cloud to blockchain. Basically, blockchain is a mechanism to store and synchronize data between parties that don't trust each other. And the level of trust could be as low as in Bitcoin, where these miners, they don't even know each other. They don't even know how many are they in the system. To a situation when you have like five or three companies that form a consortium, and they know each other, they can go to court, but they don't fully trust each other. So it's always security reasons. So as soon as you have a problem when you need to make a decentralized decisions, you need a blockchain. And actually when business people hear about blockchain, they have some picture in their mind. And I talked to like many people like that, and what I understood that they want something free, something fast, something secure, and something when they have full control. That's their expectations. Actually, they don't clearly express what exactly they want, and it took me like a year probably to understand they all talk about infrastructure. That's what they want. And infrastructure for accounting, for reconciliation, for backups, and startups, like when startups want smart contracts, they express the opinion, the thought that please remove us all the hassle with the infrastructure, with the cutoff electricity, with administrators. We just want some piece of code that just works somewhere, and we don't pay for that. customers who pay, who send money to the smart contract. So it's all about, like, I believe it's all about infrastructure game. And we are at the moment when accounting infrastructure in the whole world will be changed. It will be changed in a way that it will be using principles of blockchain and crypto in general. So there are a few challenges. That's also the reason why we don't see many blockchain applications, actually almost zero, on the mass market. And these challenges are that you have to deal with privacy issues. So obviously, if blockchain is anyhow public, then you need to protect data. Performance issues, if we talk about public blockchains. Governance, how to change the rules, for example, how to update the system. And responsibility. And I would say that the last point is the most important. For example, we've been working on decentralized auctions in Ukraine for land registry in order to build a system that allows to rent land. We didn't succeed, even though we did everything for free and integration, we did pilots and really traded this land. But then it happened that in reality, you can't really sign a contract with a decentralized system. You need some company to have a relationship with. And obviously you need a case when you can't just put a bunch of people and say, oh, just negotiate together, just reach consensus, here is the system. No, you need to tell them how they're going to do that. And usually they think about somebody who will do that for them. So every business wants to shift responsibility that they don't want to control. And they would rather pay for that. And that was quite a painful experience. And since then, we changed the approach, how we deal with enterprise systems. I want to talk a little bit about tokenization, because that's an integral part of this process of infrastructure change. So tokenization, I would define it as a transformation of asset management. In this case, it's any kind of asset. Could be gold, could be real estate, could be loyalty, could be money, could be stocks, whatever. And now everybody is talking about tokenizing these things. And basically, what the transformation of management means is that we do a shift from execution of an order of a customer towards direct management. So the example would be like, instead of writing a letter by hand and then giving it to typewriter, so it could be sent in electronic form, you write a letter on the computer in the beginning. So there is no middleman who translates one order into another. So right now, how it happens with bank, when you actually send money with a bank, you actually send an order to a bank to send you money. If bank doesn't want to do that, it won't happen. So using crypto, you actually can have full control over your account, sign a transaction, it will be executed. So Bitcoin is the best example of that. So I believe that every asset will be managed like that. So ecosystem, I just provide an example for ecosystem of stock trading. So you have apps, you have banks, exchanges, CSD, clearinghouse, and regulator. So the whole ecosystem will be tokenized. So user app will contain keys, merchant, and bank admins will contain keys, etc., etc. And how does this infrastructure differ from the traditional centralized infrastructure? So first of all these mentioned components, they will be integrated using seamless APIs, so it will be really easy to send a transaction in the system. And second is that the actual storage and execution is decentralized, so decision making is decentralized, and you don't have the central point of failure anymore. That really helps, because even within a single organization, you can have like multiple departments or between countries. When you have these decision-making servers, and if one of them is hacked, it's not a problem, because you have a consensus between them. So that's a revolution in management of accounting system. And the last thing I already mentioned, that when you sign every action with a cryptographic key, that really helps to simplify the infrastructure. So like, you can think about Bitcoin as a depository, as an exchange, and as a payment system in one thing. This one system that does all these three features. Obviously, they need to be separated from legal point of view, but from infrastructure, it's very good to have them seamlessly integrated. So last thing about how we believe it's going to evolve, because again, I met so many entrepreneurs who said like, okay, blockchain will revolutionize the world tomorrow and everything will be on blockchain, but it didn't happen. And reasons for that were I mentioned before. So I believe that in the beginning, we will have a system that is decentralized in case of, in the form of decision making, processing, storage, but it will be centralized in terms of who created the system and how the changes are sent to the system. So somebody will define rules, will provide SLA, some warranties, etc., and tell others which software to use. It's like a hybrid approach. And that's what is a little bit happening with Ethereum, for example. When Vitalik said, okay, we need to do a hard fork, and everybody said, okay, well, let's do that. So in Bitcoin, it's not possible, you can see. So like any bank system will evolve in this way, or a reconciliation system. So I expect, for example, Swift use case, there will be a new Swift that will be using regular internet, and that we will be using standard protocols, but blockchain will unite all the banks, and they will reconcile together, but there will be one entity who controls how it happens, who defines the rules. So it's much more transparent and auditable and decentralized than the approach, but you still have a center. So all these things will be present in this system. So, and what needs to be done in order to build financial internet and a system that is more transparent, etc. So we believe again that the uniform protocol of communication between financial institutions should appear. Basically, it means like a language of communication, like HTTP, but for finance. And then applications, like base applications, libraries, and modules should be open source and license free. So like with internet, you have Apache, Nginx, SMTP protocols. You can take them and use them. You don't need to pay anybody. That's how innovation spreads, because anybody can launch a website in a minute without paying a single dollar. So we are working on these applications, libraries, and like blueprints how to build accounting systems in general. Thank you very much. I'm ready. Questions?